Uma guiana que para a camisa viaja, na guiana chalaca, Once upon a time, yes, I was in the bayou.
新启迪的没有看到啊，哪里不？哪里不？新启迪的那个能不能上线？你可能进不去房间了。哎呀，没看到他上了。哪里不？能不能让新启迪的那个什么那个爬不完的麦乐姐？啊，新启迪的麦乐姐能进来吗？
他在，他叫什么名字呀？
他叫什么名字？
刘小华。
刘小华。
让他上来，让他上来。汉中的宝鸡汉中的。
刘小华，麦大姐，如果您在房间里的话，您举下手好吗？
让他上网，对，他微信房间，让他进来。
对，我们现在还没看到在线啊。
他没在线，
他平时上次你吗？
可以，可以。如果但是必须我有他的微信才行，你要推荐给我，你要把他的微信推荐给我。
So Diksha is the process of removing sins and awakening transcendental knowledge.
Diksha 就是要去除愚昧，唤醒超然的知识。
Diksha is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Lord Krishna describes.Just try to learn the truth by approaching a spiritual teacher.
在佛教赞歌当中，主 Krishna 就谈到了 Diksha 启迪，他说努力接近位灵性老师。
He says, inquire from him.
寻隐呀。
And render service.
向他为他做出服务。
The self-realized soul has seen the truth and can impart knowledge.
自我觉悟的灵魂已经见过真理，所以能受理知识。
So in this one verse in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes both the qualifications of the disciple and of the teacher.
在这个诗节当中，圣主 Krishna 既描述了门徒的资格，又形容了灵性导师的资格。
So the first qualification of the disciple is humility.
门徒的第一个资格就是谦卑。
They have to submit themselves before the superior person.
他们必须把让自己臣服一个年长的资深的人。
They have to fall down without any reservation.
他们必须毫无保留地向他去礼拜。
People should also then inquire from the spiritual teacher.
人们还应该向灵性导师询问。
The question should not be of a challenging nature.
他们应该提出挑战性的问题。
And they should not be foolish questions.
这问题也不应该愚蠢。
The question should be in relation to the path of spiritual enlightenment.
这关它必须和灵性的启蒙有关系。
And being satisfied with the inquiries, being satisfied with the answers coming from the spiritual teacher.Then one should bring the service to the spiritual teacher.
门徒对于灵性导师给予的回答感到满意之后，应该向灵性导师做出服务。
So the process of initiation is a part of the process of devotional service.
启迪的程序是奉爱服务的一部分。
If you study the nectar of devotion, Rupa Goswami has listed 64.Different items of devotional service.
如果研习《奉爱的甘露》这本书，就会发现圣卢普多萨提举了64项奉爱服务。
And the first five are all in relation to the spiritual teacher.
前五项都和灵性导师有关系。
That one has to take shelter of the spiritual teacher.
一个人必须要托付一个灵性导师。
You have to inquire.
必须向领导提出疑问。
You have to take instructions.
必须要从领导那里接受训练。
You have to accept initiation.
必须得到接受领导的启迪。
You have to understand.
必须要为领导做服务。
So in this way, Rupa Goswami describes the importance or the significance of the relationship with the spiritual teacher.
就这样，圣卢普多·戈斯瓦米就强调了，灵性导师的重要性。
We see Lord Krishna also has a spiritual teacher.
我们看到圣主 Krishna 也有灵性导师。
Lord Krishna's spiritual teacher, first of all, was Gargacharya, and then later on he went to the ashram of Sandhichani.
主 Krishna 的灵性导师首先是 Gargacharya, 之后他又去了 Sandhichani 的修院。
Then we see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also accepted initiation.
你看到是这边巴哈巴布也得到启迪。
You went to Gaya, he accepted initiation from Ishvara Puri.
他去了 Gaya, 从 Ishvara Puri 那里得到启迪。
And we see also how Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati was also accepted initiation.
我们看到圣巴提西丹达萨斯卡库也得到了启迪。
His father.Told him that he said, you cannot just simply accept your seminal father as your guru. You have to be initiated.
他说你不能仅仅是把你的生身父亲当做老师，你还得得到启迪。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati was doubtful. He thought nobody is qualified. They're all fallen. There are no good devotees anywhere.
圣巴提西丹萨斯卡库他就感到很疑惑，他觉得人们都很堕落，没有有资格的人。
But Bhaktivinoda Thakur pointed out to him, Gorky Shorthas Babi, and said, he's a very qualified person.
但是，圣巴提西丹萨斯卡库就给他指出来说，Gorky Shorthas Babaji他是有资格的人。
Now Gorky Shorthas Babaji was illiterate. He had not had any formal education.
Gorky Shorthas Babaji, 他是文盲，他没有接受过教育。
But at the same time, he was highly renowned and he was very fixed in his spiritual
path.
And he was regularly associating with Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur and coming to hear him. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was finally accepted. Actually, Gaurakishordas Babaji was reluctant because he had no disciples at the time. He was reluctant to give him a shishya. But Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was very persistent. And then when he saw the persistence and the determination, then Gaurakishordas Babaji agreed to accept
him.
Another example was Narottam Das. Narottam Das Thakur once was told to be initiated by Lokanath Swami, Lokanath Goswami. Lokanath Goswami did not have any disciples. He didn't want to take any
disciples.
So, Lord Chaitanya was coming into the dream of Narottam Das Thakur and telling him, you have to take initiation from Lokanath Goswami.
So, Chaitanya 进入到拿坦达斯塔库的梦中，就告诉他，你必须从罗格纳斯塔那过的。罗格纳，罗格纳，罗格纳。
You have to get initiation from him.
你必须从他那里得到。但是罗格纳的罗格纳不想起。But
when Narottam Das Thakur was very persistent. And he found many different ways somehow you would come to serve Lokanath Goswami. So finally, Lokanath Goswami gave in and he also accepted initiation to Narottam. So our own spiritual master and founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, he was also initiated. His initiating spiritual master was Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati. Actually, Prabhupada had met, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 11 years ago in the year 1922 when he was a young man. He first met Bhaktisiddhanta
Saraswati.
But it was not until 1933 when he was actually initiated. Srila Prabhupada described how when he first met Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, he was just a young man, he recently married, and he had young children. And but he was greatly impressed that he met a real son.
但是圣帕帕的心中说，他当时还是个年轻人，刚刚结婚，也刚刚有个小孩子，但是他就被这个沙度印象深刻。So
their paths were separated, and it was only later when Srila Prabhupada had moved to the city of what is today called Prayagraj, that Prabhupada had opened a business there, and at that time he met some members from the Gaudiya Math.
圣帕拉的就去了当代的格亚，他在那里开了一所药店。
So Gaudiya Math devotees had come there. They heard that there was a nice, pious man there. And when they met Prabhupada, then Prabhupada remembered how he met their guru, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati.
Gaudiya Math 的贡献者呢，就去找到了帕帕的，然后帕帕的就在格亚的城遇见了圣巴提斯丹萨的帕库。
So Srila Prabhupada went on to become a member of the Gaudiya Math, and he was initiated by Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati.
所以圣帕帕德就继续就是在多殿纳的那里联谊，最终得到了启迪。
So at the time of his initiation, when he was introduced to Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati said that, oh yes, I have noted this man. He likes to hear.
在启迪仪式上，当圣帕的当帕帕的被介绍给帕林老师的时候，帕林朗的老师就说，哦，我知道这个年轻人，他喜欢聆听。
So the hearing is an important qualification for the devotees.
聆听对奉献者来说是重要的品质。
We need to hear carefully.
我们还是要小心仔细的聆听。
We need to hear regularly again and again and be reminded of our spiritual identity.
我们就需要反反复复的聆听，被提醒我们的灵性身份。
And we need to hear about Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna's wonderful qualities and pastimes.
我们需要聆听 Krishna 奇妙的品德和消失光谱。
As it is said, Srimbhutam Svatita Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana Ridhyanta Stovya Bhadrani Vidunoti Surabhi. The hearing about Lord Krishna is in itself a pious activity.
这个诗节的意思是说，聆听有关 Krishna 的话题本身就是虔诚的活动。
And by hearing carefully about Lord Krishna, we can remove all the dirt from us.
仔细的聆听有关 Krishna 的提示，就能去除内心的所有污垢。
So the process of initiation in the Krishna conscious society is that devotees have to first of all practice regularly.
在 Krishna 这个当中，体育的程序就是奉献者首先要有规律的修行。
They have to come regularly to the temple and they have to appear and take part in the activities.
他们需要来到庙里，他们必须先有规律的聆听。
If they come to the temple regularly, then they will be introduced also to chanting, which is also something which has to be done regularly.
当他们到了庙里之后呢，他们在那里都学习了要每天念诵。
We were having kirtan, but we need to also chant japa. We have to learn to chant on beats.
我们有 kirtan, 但是我们还需要去 japa, 在念经上念诵。
Chanting on the beach, performing japa is our meditation on the holy name.
在念珠上念诵圣名，能治疗我们的物质疾病。
And we are required to chant a measured amount every day. At the time of initiation, we vow to chant at least 16 rounds.
我们还必须要念诵还有那个数量，在起立的时候，我们要发声，要念诵十六圈。
So it's expected that devotees will chant regularly every day. To chant 16 rounds, they have to be willing to give up about 2 hours a day to do the chanting.
所以奉献者们他们每天要愿意拿出2个小时的时间念诵。
Yeah. If you chant, you're chanting in 1 hour.You're not going to be able to chant 16 rounds.
如果每天只拿出1个小时，是不能念16圈。
So you have to chant 16 rounds. It's going to take at least 2 hours.
他们要至少每天拿出至少两个小时念诵16圈。
But these 2 hours of chanting are the very powerful process for purifying our heart.
但是这2个小时的念诵是净化我们心灵的好办法。
Chanting is maybe one of the very beginning stages of our Krishna consciousness, but it's also the perfection of our Krishna
consciousness.
When we become fit, very, when our hearts become very clean, we won't stop chanting, we will keep chanting.
当我们的心灵变得纯洁的时候，我们就停不下来，会持续不断的念诵。
So we want you to understand the importance of the chanting process.
我们就希望大家能够理解念诵的重要性。
Lord Chaitanya was asked how to recognize a devotee. And Lord Chaitanya said, anyone who chants the holy name one time, they are a devotee.
当有人问到问足乔丹尼亚如何辨别一位奉献者的时候，他说：“任何只要念过一次证明的，就是奉献者。”
So you may think, well, I chanted one time, so I must be a devotee.
你可能说念诵过一遍了，那我一定就是奉献者。
That is the beginning of Krishna consciousness.
但那只是奉献Krishna自己的开端。
We want to go on and chant regularly.When you start to chant regularly, then you will come to the higher level of Krishna consciousness. So the initiation which is given today is initiation into the chanting of Hare Krishna mantra.
今天我们做的给的启迪是启迪念诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
There are two initiations. The second initiation is a mantra initiation. At that time, Gayatri mantra is given.
还有第二次启迪，在第二次启迪上，被给予的是 Gayatri mantra.
Gayatri mantra is for those who are very steady in their practice of devotional service and who want to increase their service.
Gayatri mantra 是给那些非常稳定的并想增加奉献福的人。
Just like here in our temple, we have standards in the worship of the deity, and this deity worship and the cooking for the deity is only done by Brahmins.
就像在庙里头，崇拜神像是有标准的，只有那些有二次是婆罗门资格的人才可以做。
But the most important part is the first initiation. It's the first initiation which can take us back to Godhead.
但最重要的呢，部分是第一次起，第一次起别把我们带到灵性世界。
The chanting of the Gayatri Mantra that will can give you some realization of the Brahman.
Gayatri mantra 呢是帮助一个人觉悟到 Brahman 吧。
But chanting Hare Krishna will give us love of God.
但只唱诵 Hare Krishna 会给予我们对神的爱。
We want to chant very carefully, and chanting requires you have to follow some rules.
我们需要仔细的来念诵，而且要遵守规则。
Of course, there are four principles which everyone has to follow, and these vows will be taken today.
当然有四项规范原则，每个人都应该遵守。今天他们要八项誓言。
Right, the four principles: no intoxication, no gambling, no meat eating, no prostitution.
四项规范原则：不麻醉品、不赌博、没有非法性行为、不食肉蛋。
These principles are mentioned in the scriptures. This is not our own.Invention, but this is taken from Shastra. The symbol of religion is in the form of the bull. The bull stands on four legs, and the four legs represent the four principles of religion. Right, Satyam, truthfulness.
一个是 Satyam, 真诚。
Then Sochyam, cleanliness.
修诚清洁。
Then Daya, mercy.
Daya, 仁慈。
And Tapa, austerity.
Tapa, 行。
So, Tapa Partiality is destroyed by pride.
不行是被骄傲所摧毁。
We have to develop humility.
我们需要培养谦卑。
In the material world, we're very proud of our position, even though we have some very insignificant thing. We think of ourselves as being very important.
在物质世界，我们都很骄傲。虽然我们只有很少的资格，但是我们认为很重要。
So, humility, it's important for us to learn to give up pride.
要学习怎么放弃骄傲，这很重要。
This pride is a type of intoxication, and that intoxication will stop us from coming to Krishna.
骄傲是一种麻醉，这种骄傲会阻止我们进入克什那之国。
Then we have to also practice mercy. Mercy is showing compassion for other living entities.
接着我们要练习仁慈谦卑，然后我们就要向其他生物表达怜悯。
If we are killing animals, there's no compassion.
如果杀了动物，就不存在怜悯。
And people may say, "Well, I didn't kill anything. I'm only eating."
有人说我不亲手杀，我只是吃食。
But if you're eating, then you're also taking karma.
但是如果你吃的话，它也有业报。
So the devotees of Krishna, they will not cook any meat, they will not eat any meat, and they will not sell any meat to anyone.
主的 Krishna 的贡献者既不会吃肉，也不会去动手杀，他们也不会去给别人提供这肉食。
In this way, we will try to cultivate the quality of mercy.
我们就这样来培养仁慈的品质。
Devotees also do not take things like onion and garlic. Although these are vegetables, still they're not part of the diet in the Vaishnava devotee.
奉献者 Vaishnava 奉献者，他们也不吃洋葱、大蒜。虽然他们是蔬菜类，但是不在他们的食谱上。
Onion and garlic are.They're aphrodisiacs, which means they stimulate the passion and the lust which is there.
因为这两类食品呢，它们是能够就是让内心的色欲发酵的食品。
So, devotees very careful to avoid these kind of food stuffs. We already have a lot of lust and passion in the heart.And if you eat foods like onion and garlic, it only increases.
我们内心已经有足够的色欲和激情，再吃这两项食物呢，就更加加重了。
No, mercy is destroyed by eating these kind of foodstuffs.
就通过吃这一类食品呢，就会摧毁仁慈。
Then cleanliness is destroyed by.Association with the other sex in an illicit manner.
清洁是被那些和有异性和那些有非法的关系的异性联姻摧毁这项品质。
We are not against people married. We're not against married life. Most of our devotees in our Krishna consciousness movement are married.
我们不反对婚姻。其实这些运动的大部分奉献都是已婚的。
And we like children.
而且我们挺喜欢小孩子。
And but we want to see nice children, quality children.
但是我们希望看到的是美好的、有资格的孩子。
And we want to bring the children up to develop their Christian consciousness.
我们希望让孩子成长的时候有Krishna自觉。
So cleanliness is not only.External, but also internal.
清洁它不止指外在清洁，还有内在清洁。
So to keep our cleanliness, internal cleanliness, we have to hear and chant the holy names.
我们通过聆听唱诵圣名，保持内在清洁。
And then the fourth principle was truthfulness. Truthfulness is destroyed by things like gambling.
第四项品质是诚实，诚实是被赌博所摧毁的。
Generally, wasting time in material activities also destroys the quality of truthfulness.
在物质活动当中浪费时间也会摧毁诚实的品质。
We need to be very careful to try to utilize our time properly in this material world.
我们需要在这个物质世界呢，正确的来利用光阴。
Human life is very special. It's very, we're very fortunate of the human body.
我们拥有人体生命是非常幸运的。
There are so many other species of life less fortunate.
有那么多的生物他们不那么幸运。
So we do want to be very careful to make the best use of every moment in this body.
所以我们要小心翼翼地利用好我们在这个人体生命当中的每分每秒。
And if we are wasting our time, then we're simply gambling with our time.
如果我们浪费时间，那么我们就是在用光阴去赌博。
And in this way, we'll develop the habit of being untruthful.
就这样，我们就养成了不诚实的品质了。
So these four principles are there for everyone, not just for only for the gopis, but for all civilized people.
这四项品质不仅是给贡献者，针对贡献者的，是所有文明的人都应该有的。
But people who are practicing Krishna consciousness, then they have to do other things as well. They have to, as well as the four principles, they have to also chant the holy name.
但是 Krishna 世界的贡献者，他们不只要遵守这四项原则，还要唱诵圣
名。And they have to do the most, they have to do service for the pleasure of Krishna.
他们还要为了取悦 Krishna 去做服务。
To develop an interest in hearing the teachings of Krishna from Srimad Bhagavatam.
他们要对从圣经国家版坛当中名字关于 Krishna 的提示感兴趣。
So in the chanting of the holy name of Lord Krishna, there are 10 offenses to be avoided.
在唱诵 Krishna 圣名的过程中，要避免十项冒犯。
These 10 offenses are important for all the devotees, which recite them every morning here in the temple room.
即使唱诵圣名十戒很重要，我们在庙里每天早上都念诵。
People often hear the offenses and they recite the offenses.But they don't always understand their offenses.
人们会聆听到这些相貌犯，甚至背诵，但是他们不明白懂。
So the first offense is to blaspheme the devotees who have dedicated their life to propagating the holy name.
第一项冒犯就是冒犯亵渎、献出一生全圣名的贡献者。
So to blaspheme the devotees is a serious offense, and his attempt may obstruct.The growth of our Kripa of devotion.
冒犯亵渎贡献者非常严重，会阻碍我们奉爱爬藤的生长。
We must be very careful to develop an appreciation for the devotees, not to be critical of other devotees.
你需要培养欣赏贡献者的品质，而不是对贡献者吹毛求疵。
We're encouraged to see our own faults and to see the good in others.
我们被鼓励着要看自身的缺点，而不要挑别人的毛病。
And to serve, to give service to the devotees is also very valuable.
给奉献者做服务也是非常有价值、珍贵的。
We want to avoid ever committing offenses against the devotees.
我们希望能避免对贡献者的冒犯。
So、the mad elephant offense is the blaspheme devotees.
疯狂的风向的冒犯就是批评亵渎贡献者。
It's compared to a mad elephant because if you bring an elephant into the garden, it will trample over all the plants. It will kill everything.
它之所以被比喻为是风向是因为当风向闯入花园的时候，它会践踏一切。
In a similar way, offenses against the devotee will destroy our creature of devotion.
同样的，冒犯奉献者会摧毁我们奉爱的爬藤。
We have to be very cautious.
我们也所以我们要小心，一定要对父亲的友善。
So how to avoid offending them? Simply see the good in
them. 那怎么避免冒犯贡献人呢？就是只是看他们的优点和长处。
Just see our own faults. Don't see the faults in others.
只瞧自己的毛病和缺点，不要看别人的缺点。
If you're always criticizing somebody for doing things, this is not a good sign.
如果我们总是一味的批评贡献者，这不是一个很好的迹象。
They want someone to work nicely and cooperation with others.
我们要学习怎么跟其他的贡献者很好的合作。
For coming to the Krishna consciousness movement is to throw away from the material world.
来进入到 Krishna 直觉运动当中。就是要远离物质世界。
Krishna consciousness is not in the Kali Yuga.
Krishna 知觉呢，不仅仅存在于卡利年代。
The material world is in the Kali Yuga.
物质世界有卡利年代。
So in the Kali Yuga, there's always quarrel and argument, confusion, disagreement between people.
在卡利年代呢，人们总是彼此争吵。有不同的意见彼此。
But if we are in Krishna consciousness, we will be very careful to avoid all this quarreling, arguing.
但是如果我们在 Krishna 直觉当中，我们从未避免跟别人争吵辩论。
Some devotees would often write to Prabhupada and tell him about what's happening in the temple. So if a devotee wrote to Prabhupada,and told him how all the devotees are quarreling and arguing with each other, then Prabhupada would feel very disturbed and upset.
贡献者呢，总是给帕帕的那个写信，他们说庙里的事情。所以当帕帕得知贡献者们彼此之间争吵不和的时候，他就会感到很打扰。
So this is a neophyte tendency, to quarrel and to argue with each other.
他说：“这是初级贡献者的倾向，就是彼此总在那里争吵辩论。”
We have to be very careful to avoid this neophyte.
所以我们要很小心避免这种初级者的倾向。
But if Prabhupada got a letter from devotees where all the devotees are, the devotee wrote telling Prabhupada how all the devotees are working hard, preaching, distributing books.And doing too many activities, Prabhupada would feel very happy.
帕帕德每当收到一封信，在描述贡献者之间是怎么在那里传教、派出努力工作的时候，他就会特别满意。
Prabhupada liked to see the devotees working together, helping each other and appreciating each other's efforts.
他希望看到贡献者彼此合作。
Now, when people come to Krishna consciousness, often in the beginning, they're very happy and they feel very good and they appreciate everyone and they see all the good qualities in people.
当人们刚刚来到 Krishna 世界，当他们都很兴高采烈，很欣赏贡献者，很愉快。
But after some time, gradually they start.
但过一段时间呢，他们就会挑对方的毛病开始抱怨。
And when they start to see faults and criticize devotees, then their devotional service will be greatly weakened.
他们一旦看奉献者的缺点，开始批评奉献者，他们的奉爱服务就被削弱了。
In the beginning, they're very enthusiastic, very happy, and they're respecting everyone.
一开始他们特别的有热情，特别高兴，他们尊重每一个人。
So at that time they make a lot of progress, make a lot of advancement.
在那个时候，他们的进步是特别飞速的。
But when they start to see faults, to criticize, and complain, then their devotional service is reduced a lot.
随后呢，当他们开始挑贡献者的毛病，开始抱怨， 开始争吵的时候，他们的奉献服务就速度变缓了。
So this point about devotional service and the working together, not offending devotees, this is the mad elephant. To offend them, this is the mad elephant.
就对奉献者的这种冒犯，批评奉献者被比喻为风向的冒犯。
So then the second offense is to consider the names of the demigods, like Lord Shiva, or Lord Brahma, to be equal to or independent the name of Lord Vishnu.
第二项冒犯是认为像 Brahma, Shiva 这样的名字和主 Vishnu 的名字是一样的，或独立于主 Vishnu 的名字。
Now there are many temples, different gods. You see there's temples of Lord Shiva. Even if you go to India, Puskar, there's temples for Lord Brahma there.
在印度呢就有不同的半神的庙，有 Shiva 的庙，在 Puskar 有主 Brahma 的庙。
So there are different deities, different demigods.And people may worship, some people like to worship Lord Ganesh. You can see that we have a Lord Ganesh here.
还有的人崇拜不同的半神呢。Ganesh, 我们在这里有 Ganesh.
So some people, they worship Ganesh as the Supreme Lord.
但有的人把 Ganesh 当成至尊主来崇拜。
And other people, they worship Lord Shiva. Some people will worship Mother Durga.
有些人崇拜主 Shiva， 有些人还崇拜 Durga 母亲。
So they consider the worship of these other gods to be equal to the worship of Vishnu or Krishna。
他们认为对这些其他半神的崇拜和对主 Vishnu 和 Krishna 的崇拜是平等的。
But in this Vaishnava, we are practicing the teachings of Vaishnavism here in this temple.We consider Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, the Supreme.
但是我们在这里修习的是 Vaishnava， 所以我们认为 Krishna， Vishnu 是至尊的。
Originally, there was only one Lord worshipped.
最开始呢是只有一位主被崇拜。
But gradually, with the deterioration of the qualities of people in the course of time, so many other different
但随着卡密年代，人们的品质逐渐堕落败坏，就介绍进了其他的真理。
In the Satya Yuga, the very first age, the golden age, everyone was like a Paramahansa. They were all princes. They were all very simple people.
在第一个年代，三个年代，每个人都是崇高的 Paramahansa， 至尊天主。
And all the religious principles were present in full. Nobody was a meat eater or a gambler or an intoxicator or a womanizer.
而且所有的宗教原则都百分之百的存在在那里，没有人是肉食和赌博的，追逐女人的。
But gradually, as time moved on and we come to the other ages, then there's a deterioration and the different irreligious qualities develop.
但随着时间的进展，就是他们的品质就越来越少，逐渐的堕落。
And with the development of their religion, they introduced the worship of so many other gods.
随着非宗教的盛行，他们就引进了其他的神。
And people were now just confused about who is actually God.
人们就很困惑，谁是至尊主？
So we should understand that the chanting of the holy names of Lord Vishnu or Lord Krishna is this, they are the real names which should be chanted. And it's much, you cannot chant names of other gods.
所以我们要明白主 Vishnu, Krishna 的圣名是我们应当唱诵的，而应该唱诵其他名字。
It is said even in relation to the names of the Lord that 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu is equal to one name of Lord Rama.
念一千遍 Vishnu 的名字，就相当于念诵一遍 Rama。
This is a statement in the scripture.
这是经典的结论。
Rame Rame Namo Rame Sahasranamabhistuyam Sri Rama Nama Karanini. The holy Lord Vishnu, there's a prayer which is called Vishnu Sahasranam, 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu. So Mother Parvati was going to recite Vishnu Sahasranam, but her husband, Lord Shiva, told her, while he spoke the verse which I just recited, he told her, you don't need to recite all those names of Lord Vishnu, just chant the name of Lord Rama.
So, 多个母亲呢，她每天会念诵，就是Vishnu的一千个名字，然后她的丈夫主事呢就告诉你，你没有必要念诵，一千遍的Vishnu名字，你只需要念一遍子Rama名字。And
then there's another scriptural statement which said, three times chanting the name of Lord Rama is equal to one name of Lord Krishna.
经典当中还这样说，念诵三遍Rama的名字，就先等于念诵一遍Krishna的名字。
So if you like to chant the name of Lord Vishnu, we don't have any objection. We also offer our respects and worship to Lord Vishnu.
如果谁喜欢这样Vishnu的名字呢，我们不反对，我们也念Vishnu的名字。We
also celebrate the appearance of all the different avatars of Lord Vishnu.
我们也庆祝主Vishnu的不同的化身的显现日。But
when it comes to chanting, we chant the holy name of Lord Krishna.
但是当唱诵圣名的时候呢，我们唱诵的是 Krishna 的名字。Because
the name of Lord Krishna has supreme power.
因为主 Krishna 的圣名是有至高无上的力量。So
it happened one time, one of the Gandharvas was in the association of young ladies, and he began to joke and flirt with the young ladies.
有一次呢，有一位Gandharva，他就和那些年轻的女子呢，在那里开玩笑。And
the Prajapatis who were present, they took offense from his behavior, and they cursed this young man that he should take birth as a sutra.
在场的Prajapati们就对这位Gandharva的行为举止就感到受到了冒犯，他们诅咒这Gandharva成为宿主。So
you have to be very careful. Don't joke. And don't joke. If you jokingly think you're going to chant the names of other gods, then you may get in trouble.
所以我们在开玩笑，不要开玩笑，拿半神的名字开玩笑。
So, the third offense is to disobey the orders of the spiritual teacher. Now, spiritual teacher is not just the person who gives initiation, it's all the spiritual teachers.
灵性导师指的是启迪灵导师，是所有灵导师。We
have first of most important is we have the founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, and he is the Shiksha Guru for all the members of this group. So Srila Prabhupada gives instructions there in his books also and other sources like lectures and letters.
圣帕帕德就在他的书籍、讲课、信件当中就给出了训语。Most
important are Srila Prabhupada's books.
最重要的是 Srila Prabhupada的书籍。
Letters are more personal. Prabhupada write to individuals.
信件呢是表私人的，他会给个人写信。
So we want to be faithful and chaste. We should try to follow the instructions of Srila Prabhupada.
如果我们想忠心耿耿的话，就要追随圣帕帕的训语。Just
like every morning, we sing the Guru Vastikam at Mangal Arti. So then we sing by the mercy of the spiritual master, we get the mercy of Krishna.
每天早上我们唱诵八颂名诗的时候，最后一条就是急着灵性导师的人死，我们得到 Krishna 的恩赐。And
without the mercy of the spiritual master, then we will only be happy.
没有灵性导师的仁慈，在我们自我觉悟的道路上只有不灭。
So very important is to get the mercy of the spiritual teachers.
所以得到灵性导师的仁慈非常重要。
And to get their mercy, what we have to follow their teaching.
为了得到他们的仁慈呢，我们必须要遵随他们的教导。
There was one devotee, he was serving the deities, and he was such an advanced devotee, he was able to talk to the deities.
曾经呢，有一位奉献者，他服务神像，他是这么进步，甚至可以跟神像交流。
So other devotees, they found out that this one devotee, he talks to the deities, you know, the deities are talking to him.
其他的奉献者就发现，这位奉献者竟然可以跟神像直接交流。
So one of the devotees said, can you ask the deities about me? Am I going to get liberation at the end of this life?
其中有一位奉献者就央求这位，就这位能跟神像交流的奉献者说，你能不能问一下神像，我这事能不能得到解脱？
So Didi, so really it's a good devotee at the end of life, people go back to our abode, much mind with the Supreme Lord.
那么你作为很好的奉献者，那么在他结束这一生的时候就能回到自己的去所。
So the devotee thought, I should ask about myself. He said, what about me? Am I also going to get to go back? Will I also be liberated at the end of life?
但这个奉献者最后就寻思了，那我们为什么不问问我自己呢？我这一生结束之后，我自己能不能回到灵性世界
？So Deity said, "No, you're not going to go back to God because you don't serve people."
结果神像竟然对他说：“不行，你这一世回不去，因为你不服务奉献者。
You just simply serve me. I'm the Deity. You don't serve the Lord. It's all you do is serve me.And the temple never served me.
你只是服务我，服务神像，在庙里，在那里服务神像，你不服务奉献。
So the devotee became very worried.
我这奉献者就担心了。哦天哪，我竟然回不去了。
So he became very conscious to take every opportunity to serve the devotee.
然后他就特别的警觉，抓住每一个机会奉献。
They have to take instructions. We have to learn from by hearing from many different sources.
所以我们必须要接受训斥，我们从各个来源来聆听。
We may not be speaking the deities, but Krishna is speaking to us in the heart.
我们可能不能跟神像交流。但是 Krishna 在内心在对我们讲话。
In the heart, Krishna is telling many what you should be doing.
在内心 ，Krishna 告诉我们很多事情该做什么。
We have to hear Krishna's words.
我们要聆听 Krishna 的讲话。
And we have to act according to his instructions.
我们要根据他的心语相应的采取行动。
And the spiritual master and the spiritual teacher speak, they're also there.They're the manifestation of Krishna.
当灵性导师讲话的时候，灵性导师也是我们内心的主的展示和代表。
So then the fourth offense is to blaspheme the Vedic literature or literature that pursues the Vedic version.
第四项冒犯是冒犯性伟达文献和基于伟达信誉写成的文献。
We should not criticize any of the books. We should not say, "Oh, this book is not good. This is not important. Don't read this book." We should appreciate all the scriptures.
我们不能批评书籍，说这写的不好，这个书不好。我们要尊重书籍，尊重经典。
Of course, some scriptures are meant for people who are not practicing bhakti yoga. Some books are for people.Practicing maybe other kinds of yoga.
当然有的书籍呢，不是给那些练动漫瑜伽的人写的，是练其他瑜伽的。
But they're also part of the Vedic wisdom, and we should respect them.
他们也是伟达文献的智慧的展示，我们要尊重。
But we should give special respect to the books written by the founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada.
我们应该对于我们的奠基聆听导师师父帕帕写的书籍更更的尊重。
In our Krishna consciousness movement, we have our Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Chaitanya Charitamrita.
在 Krishna 之间运动当中，我们有国家藏歌、圣典国家晚安和 Chaitanya Charitamrita.
And then we have also books like Nectar of Devotion.
还有父爱的甘露。
So these books are very important for us. We need to study them. We need to learn from this.
这些书呢对我们很重要，我们要研习。
So to help people to do that, we have courses.
所以为了帮助人们研习呢，我们就对奉献，我们真的奉献给了你的课程。
Bhagavad Gita course, we have many people attend our Bhagavad Gita courses online.
有许多人呢，就会在线上、网上、平时国家上上课的讲座。
We have, for example, one course on the Bhagavad Gita. They cover a chapter. One each class is 1 hour, so 1 hour a day, and in each day they will cover one chapter of the Bhagavad Gita.
有一个课程，奉献的课程是每天一个小时，这一个小时呢，就讲国家上课的一章。
And that's a free course.
这是免费的课。
So, if you're not devotees, you should take the time. It's now an opportunity to learn about the body.
所以，不管是奉献者或奉献，都应该利用这个机会来学习。
And we have these courses going on in many different languages.
不像这样的课程呢，有许多各种语言。
And they're online, they're available online.
通常就是线网上的课。
So, open to people everywhere.
所以就是世界各地的人都可以去学。
So, we encourage the devotees, you must just try to be ready.
我们鼓励奉献者要有规律的阅读。
In our life, we should try to read all Prabhupada's books.
我们在此生当中呢，应该阅读圣帕帕所有书籍。
And some devotees, they will read Prabhupada's books every year. In the course of 1 year, they read all of Prabhupada's books.
有的奉献者呢，他们每年都会把帕帕的书读一遍。
So you can also try to read more.
所以你们可以努力的去更多的阅读。
Then the fifth offense is to give some interpretation of the holy name.
第五个冒犯就是给圣名提解释圣名。
The sixth offense is to consider the glories of chanting Hare Krishna as a imagination.
第六个冒犯是认为唱诵 Hare Krishna 的荣耀凭空虚想。
Just like it is sometimes said, one time chanting the holy name can destroy unlimited amounts of sinful reactions.
就像经典中有这样一句话，唱诵 Krishna 的一遍圣名就可以摧毁无数的自我反应。
So someone may think, oh, how is it possible? No, I don't believe it's possible.
有些人就想，哎，这怎么可能啊？我不信。
So this is nothing.
有这种想法是一种冒犯。
You should understand it's possible, but there's quality in it.
我们要明白呢，这是可能的，只是唱诵圣名的这个质量。
The seventh offense is to commit sinful activities in the strength of chanting.
第七项冒犯是急着唱诵圣名的力量行
动。So someone may think, oh, I'm going to party tonight, maybe I'll drink something, maybe I'll do something which is not proper, and maybe tomorrow I'll chant Hare Krishna to make up for it.
有的人想，哎，今天我去俱乐部去，喝点什么，做点什么。恰当时明天早上我给你念诵。
So,
I'll go to the club and drink something and eat something.
Tomorrow
morning, I'll try. Oh, 明天我多念点
Eighth offense is to consider chanting Hare Krishna to be an auspicious ritualistic activity.
第八项冒犯里认为唱诵 Hare Krishna 是一个吉祥的仪式性的。
So we chant Hare Krishna not to just get some pious activity, but we want to develop our devotion.
我们唱诵 Hare Krishna 并不是想吃一点钱跟菩萨，不是要培养奉爱。
The goal is to develop love for Krishna.
我们的目标是培养对 Krishna 的爱。
We don't just want to get rid of our bad karma. We don't just want pious activities. We want to get free of karma.
我们不是说想要积累点钱跟活动，想摆脱恶业。
And the ninth offense to instruct faithless persons about the glories of the holy name.
第九项冒犯是对毫无信心的人想要圣人的荣耀。
Now we can tell anyone to chant Hare Krishna.
我们可以告诉任何人去念 Hare Krishna.
We were outside yesterday chanting Hare Krishna. There were hundreds of thousands of people around.We were giving the holy name to everyone.
我们昨天下午出去阿里纳的时候，我们向成千上万的人，给他们唱诵了圣名。
So it's not wrong to tell people to chant Hare Krishna.
告诉别人要念 Hare Krishna 这点都错误。
But we have to awaken their faith also in the Hare Krishna mantra.
我们也要唤醒他们对 Hare Krishna 的信心。
And we do that by kirtan, by prasadam, and by teaching basic philosophy.
我们通过 kirtan, prasadam 及教导基本的哲学培养他们的信心。
Just like you have to tell them you're not the body, you're not in control of your mind and senses.
就好像我们告诉人们，你们不是你们的躯体，你们无法控制的感官和心理。
So we can explain the basic point of it.
我们可以教导他们 Krishna 是觉得基本道理。
But you don't want to tell them too much about the benefit of how you don't want to explain higher things. You want to get difficult, you want to divide the field.
所以不能一上来就给他们讲非常崇高的，一开始要培养他们的基本的信心。
And as they develop faith, then they become more qualified.
随着他们培养起信心，就有资格去聆听唱诵。
And then the tenth offense is to maintain material attachment and not love completely.
第十项冒犯就是还有物质的依附，对唱诵没有完全的信心。
And then the sixth is also offensive to the inattentive marchers.
唱诵圣名不专心也是一项冒犯。
So inattention is the seed of all offenses.专注的冒犯。
我们在念诵的时候就要尽量避免这些冒犯。
Alright, so David, we just have to give initiation for this one lady.
So, 今天呢，我们给这位女士来起名。
So, this might be the secret that she's coming from. Far away.
她是来自非常遥远的地方。
Actually, not having much association, not having really any association where she lives. So she goes to visit the devotees sometimes in other towns. And sometimes other ladies go to visit her.
有的时候呢，别的来自别的地方的工作人员去他家。
Especially Archimurti Manaji and Yamuna Lakshmi Manaji and Yamuna Sisi.
Archimurti Manaji and Yamuna Lakshmi Manaji. They will come to us.
So, Amish, we have to ask you, what are the four offenses? First, you come forward. She already named Ramachandra Great Consciousness. Your name is Radha Gopinath Devi Das.
葫芦问你四个规范原则。四个规范，我们的四个规范。
每天你送多少船？
每天念诵多少圈？
它是宝鸡的，
属于宝鸡附近的一个汉族。那个江南山鸡，你对它了解吗？一个人可以说。他们是宝鸡的，那个汉族吗？
OK， 我们给你们一个 Hamsa Avatari。
Hamsa Avatari。
到时候写给你，到时候写给你，
那没不说。
不用不写你的。
等一下，我们写给你两个。
等一下，我写给你。好。
他那个念字，他那个念字，不让我给带出去。
你可以带回去。
好。
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 现在开始做火锅。I am.